Adam?
Well, not a lot of time, and no candidate is really taking much stock in these results, at least not right now. Ayotte and Hodes spent part of their day on the seacoast trying to get as many voters to hear their message as possible. There's little either candidate can really do or say at this point. Now it's up to voter turnout.
Senate hopeful Kelly Ayotte spent the Monday before Election Day meeting voters at this coffee shop in Portsmouth. She spent part of the day on the seacoast before heading to Wolfboro and Manchester to wrap up her final push.
Just out and about, trying to talk to as many people as possible. It started at a veterans breakfast this morning.
Her opponent, Congressman Paul Hodes, talked to young voters at UNH before traveling to Southern New Hampshire University in the final hours before Election Day.
We have a big field effort, a big get out the vote effort, and we're doing a lot with kids because the young vote is really important. They're our future.
The race between both candidates has been watched nationwide, and the latest WMUR-UNH poll shows Ayotte is picking up speed heading into Tuesday, with Hodes losing ground.
The Senate race is getting a little bit out of hand here. We're seeing that Kelly Ayotte, who's led throughout this entire race, is now holding a fairly significant lead. 54% of likely voters say they're going to vote for Kelly Ayotte. Only 36% say they're going to vote for Paul Hodes.
UNH pollster Andy Smith says by now, 72% of surveyed voters say they've definitely decided who they're picking in Tuesday's election. A national Republican wave certainly helped in Ayotte's run, and Smith says Ayotte's last-minute primary win helped solidify her political message, and it is resonating with voters.
She's doing better among her partisans. Her partisans are more motivated than Democrats. Republicans are more motivated than Democrats. And the independents are breaking to Ayotte. So it's a really hard, it's going to be very, very difficult, if not impossible, for Hodes to pull this out.
Well, Hodes today is still very confident his grassroots efforts will pay off come tomorrow. And tonight, the president is even holding a telephone town hall meeting for him. Neither candidate is worrying too much about the numbers because really the only important number won't be known until tomorrow night. Reporting live, Adam Harding, WMUR News 9.